Hey, what's going on? I'm Sam from Lytei, and today we're in Aspen, Colorado. Let's go check out the Hotel Jerome.
The lighting discussion started with the general manager reaching out to me saying, we've got this outdated lighting. They were going through the remodel of and the addition of the new speakeasy and the exterior space. And as they were going through that process, they realized that their facade lighting was old, tired, half of it wasn't working. All of the monopoints were incandescent. You saw the building at night, you couldn't even tell there was linear at the top of the building. And it wasn't energy efficient, it was not maintenance friendly.
The existing conditions were corroded, stripped out, boxes not mounted properly.
He actually took me to the rooftop of the building one day to show me what he was dealing with on a maintenance side of things. And he said, these fixtures are almost impossible to relamp. The most important thing for them was color temperature. Second most important was ease of maintenance, or zero maintenance, really. So next we went into looking at samples together so that they could understand. We're uplighting sections of this beautiful historic brick, and we had optics, you know, I think it was down to 10 degrees on almost any given fixture up to, you know, 60. And so talking through that design process and the spec availability with the team, it was about what is the end result going to look like versus what you have now. The end result is going to make the facade of this beautiful historic building stand out more. It's going to bring it back to life.
The one advantage that was key here was the lighting designer choosing the fixture that was very flexible and had plenty of rotation range to be adjusted to be able to create a even surface regardless of the conditions that we were faced with in the field.
They trusted us to make the right call, and on our end that included a nighttime mock-up. We got several fixtures with several different optics, several different color temperatures. And we did a real-time mock-up on site with the building. We were lucky to have a full-scale model to do the mock-up on. So
if a fixture would not have been chosen quite as well with the adjustability and the means and methods of installation, it may not have turned out as successful as it did.
There were a couple of challenges that we had during the design, one of which was that we had to go through the HPC, Historic Preservation Committee, and talk them through what we wanted to do with the design and how that was going to affect the look of the building, how it was going to change the lighting.
The project was going to require a 120-foot boom lift, and we required traffic control from four different directions at all times before they allow the permit to be approved. The uniqueness of this project was mostly in the layout and understanding of how the project was going to go down beforehand. There was no room for mistakes. There was no room for oversight, missing a detail for what was required. Perhaps more time went into this project just in understanding and the logistics of the job to accomplish in a week time period that was allowed.
And part of the preparation for meeting with the city and the Historic Preservation Committee was driving around Aspen and seeing what kind of lighting the other historic buildings had around Aspen. None of them ever had lighting like the Hotel Jerome. And none of them ever will. Dark sky is a big thing in Aspen, and people have very strong opinions on it. I don't think that everyone totally understands how limited we are with exterior lighting in and around Aspen, but it plays a big part in our design, and you know, we have to be creative. So convincing them that we were going to replace the uplights with better uplights was a little bit challenging, but I mean, I think they knew in the end that this building is so iconic that you know, we needed to bring her back to life in the way that she's always been lit.
The surface level that we were applying to was not as intact as what we were hoping it was going to be. Demo and installation had to occur simultaneously. The fastening was a challenge to be able to get the light to be even across the facade of the building, which is very important. There was no chance for coming back and redoing this. It all had to be done properly the first time.
So that was one challenge. And then the other challenge was that the way that they had previously mounted the junction boxes to the stone on the building was a little janky.
It was very important that we understood the anchoring, strapping methods of equipment that we installed to be able to make it to where it didn't damage or interfere with the actual historical preservation of the project.
The team was definitely a big part of this project, and there were a lot of team members. The City of Aspen officials and the HPC officials had to review what we were doing and ultimately sign off on the design and the new specifications that we were proposing. The general manager worked with me to review samples and to review color temperatures and fixture finishes.
And it's a privilege for us to be able to know that with the City of Aspen and our close relationship that we can perform and make those expectations become real.
So the end result, I didn't know what to expect. I was nervous.
Overall, this project was a really enjoyable project. Perhaps one of the more rewarding sides of this project was really never noticed as a local scene, the operators of the company of Hotel Jerome, or perhaps even the city itself, as it was such a streamlined venture between LaCruz Strieb Lighting and Lasser Electric.
I had gotten a few tidbits of feedback here and there, but nothing solid. And so when I saw it myself for the first time, I was excited. The Hotel Jerome was great to work with. They let us do what we do best, and they trusted us to make the right decisions and trusted us to help them through the process, especially with the city. And there was nothing that didn't happen that we wanted to happen on this project. So when they saw the end result, it was pretty astounding. We submitted for IES award and we got an award of merit, and it feels great. I mean, it always feels good to be recognized, you know, but especially on this project, we were all really excited to be a part of it, and really, because it is such a big part of Aspen and the life, it's the heart of the City of Aspen, honestly. And so we were so excited to be a part of it and so excited to be recognized for the design and helping update the lighting and bring it back to life.